Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome to Winter NAMM 2020. You're here with the kid, Jeremy Varejo, and I am with Guillaume from Two Notes Audio. It's already been announced, the Captor X, but Guillaume's going to walk us through it, and this is something that you should all be very excited about.
Hey Jeremy. Well, I'm pretty excited too.
I'm sure.
Well, you probably know about the rest of the Torpedo line, and you know we released the original Torpedo Captor 3 years ago and the Torpedo Cab M last year. You can think of that unit of the combination of the original analog captor and the Cab M, but it's actually much more than that. So it's the same form factor as the captor. So I wanted, that's the name, right?
Yeah.
I wanted something that can fit in a gig bag that's not too heavy on top of an amp. I mean, it just works. I wanted to look a little bit analog, just a handful of options. And if you wanna, well, dig into it, you can access every parameter with USB, Bluetooth control, iPad, iPhone, Android, whatever you like. So it's we keep what we have that was great in Cab M and Captor, put it in the same Captor enclosure, and we actually add a few little things that I think are pretty cool. So one major difference is we now have two outputs,
right?
So we added a new reverb algorithm.
Right.
And what we call the twin tracker. So the new reverb, I entirely rewrote that algorithm. I mean, the Cab M reverb is pretty cool. I just wanted something that could sound like well longer, or if you're not aiming at doing like room modeling, but rather using it as an effect.
Right.
So this one is way better if you want to just use reverb, you want some ambient sound. So it's pretty cool. And you have access through that knob, the space knob here,
okay,
to stereo expansion. So the way it works, you have your stereo reverb, and you can get it to be around you. It's just great. You play at night with your tube amp, just want something that's just comfy surrounding, a little bit less dry than what you have in the Torpedo Cab, because it's mono.
Right.
Here, even if the cabinet simulation part is still mono, with the reverb, you get it to sound like all around you, and that's great. The twin tracker is a bit different. It's also about creating a stereo out of mono, but in a different way. Twin tracker actually adds another guitarist next to you.
Yeah, right.
So in that case, the space knob is actually how accurate and tight the other guitarist is. So if you keep it to the left, well, it's pretty tight, and the more you push it, well, the more the guy is drunk.
So basically, if it's all the way to the left, which is the tightest, is like me, because I am known for being incredibly tight when I'm multi-tracking. It's my superpower. But if I'm playing, like you said, with Ace Frehley, it'll be all the way over to the right.
I didn't say that.
No, you. I did, but...
But yes, you get it.
Okay.
So you can use it as a creative effect. If you push it, you can get some funny sounds, like really good. But if you use it really to double track, or for example, you're on stage, you're the only guitarist in the band, but the front of house person just want to, well, have the guitar a little bit more spread out.
Sure.
That's the thing you need. They used to do like some kind of delay stuff. That's not great. This works way better.
Fantastic.
Really way better. So that's the theory part. I wanted to have like the best headphones experience you could have, like immersive, like having fun. It's no like bullshit marketing. Like,
yeah.
It's really a ton of fun. So to me, this unit is more like something that's amazing to use if you're just a guitarist. If you're not even interested in recording,
right,
you'll have a ton of fun just using the headphones out. But if you're serious about recording, it's still a Torpedo. It's still a tuner's product.
Yeah.
You have a proper DI out. You have all the you can go down the rabbit hole and touch everything, have plenty of cabinets, microphone position, all of that is still here. There is an interesting new thing here. So on the original Captor, you had just one level of attenuation, minus 20. On this one, we added a minus 38 because... Well, a lot of our users are actually using just their amp. They want to use their amp at home. They are not necessarily players to go on tours, right? So when you play at home, and for example, we have on the booth here a Plexi, well, it can get pretty loud, right? Turn all the way down this to minus 38, and you can still have a conversation while you're playing your Plexi.
Yeah.
And I wanted that as... So with that attenuation, it's not the same we do with the reload, which is like it's very flat, doesn't affect your tone, and it's a continuous attenuation. This one, I wanted it to sound good, which is a different approach.
Sure.
So we do touch the sound, but in a way I think you like.
Right.
So it's a...
It'll still feel like your amp. It'll still feel like what you want to hear, but it's going to give you a nice full addition to the tone. It's going to push the tone a little bit.
Yes, and because when you play at a lower volume, the feeling changes quite a bit.
Absolutely.
So I'm working on that. With the reload, what you can do, you have what we call the contour knob that let you adjust for that thing. We don't have that here, but I think it's pretty good. Yeah. I think it works great. On the front, so probably you know about the two knots remote, torpedo remote, and all you can do with the mic position and everything. But sometimes you don't want to put you don't want to have your phone out, tablet or whatever, because you're on stage, you need to be fast. So the voicing here, that's a new control. The voicing will affect all the presets at once.
Okay.
So you can think about it as a master EQ on top of it.
A global EQ. Yep.
Exactly. So it's not saved with your preset. It's something you just adjust. Like, for example, your sound guy tells you, well, I need a little bit more high end or you need to fit better in the mix, so give me more mids. Well, this is like a loudness EQ, so we'll push low and high or push the mids.
Very good.
And it's very fast.
Yep.
I mean, you adjust the taste, don't think about it, and it's a fast EQ setting, so you don't have to dig into the parameters. You have six presets here that would probably fit most people's need, but we have the tiny MIDI here, so we use TRS jack into a regular MIDI cable that we provide with the unit. So
wait. You provide it with the unit.
Yes.
No additional purchase. I know Henning already touched on this, but that is awesome, right? I mean,
yeah, we don't like that too much. Like, because we know you want to use it, right? So it's just there. And so you can access 128 presets.
Okay.
Every parameter on the product you can access with MIDI.
Okay.
So it's not just those six.
Right.
And so this is the USB control for Torpedo Remote. What do we forget? Oh, maybe how much it costs.
Oh, well, let's talk this. It's got to be $899.
It is not.
$799.
We're
not going to do that.
No, it's $549.
That's fantastic. So, so for anyone that watches my channel, for the tens of people that watch my channel, I've been using Two Note stuff for the last couple of years now. It is at the heart of everything that I do, and I saw this come out, and I'm super excited, right? So, the good thing about I think what you guys do is something like the Captor X doesn't make anything else you own obsolete, right? This adds to an arsenal of stuff you have, right? So I use my Torpedo Studio at home. I use my Captor here. I have my Captor at NAMM, and I'm using it for amp captures. And I have a Cab M, right? So if I'm using a modeler, like my Line 6 HX Stomp, it only gives you six blocks. So the reverb is so good on the Cab M for my needs that I free up a block on my modeler, and I run the reverb on the Cab M. And if you're saying that this is an enhanced version of that reverb or a rethought, it's phenomenal because I love the reverb there.
You will get it in the Cab M. So after this is released in March, we will rule out the new reverb into Cab M. But Cab M is mono, so you won't get the stereo, but you'll get the new algorithm.
Right. So
plus a few extras.
So this is great. I think for value for dollar, this does a ton of shit.
Oh yeah.
This does a ton of shit.
I forgot about telling you about something. So you may not be a sound engineer. You may not be interested in turning too many knobs or whatever.
Yeah.
We added a new. So you know, on the remote you have those racks unit.
Yes.
On the remote we added a new rack which is an enhancer, and it's a three knob thing.
Yeah.
You will try it. You will never switch it off.
Okay.
You will never switch it off.
All right. So last thing I'll say, I'm sure, like just like everything else, I mean, when I got my studio, I literally never opened the manual. Very easy to get into. Programming on the unit is easy. Using the captors are easy. Everything I've used from you guys is super intuitive. So it's designed for guitar players because basically, I mean, I'm an idiot. I mean, you guys are probably smarter than me, but I guarantee you that this will be thought out in a way that you can just plug it in, follow the diagram, and play, and just start making music and not mucking about with having to use an editor or any of that stuff. I'm very excited for this. Very excited. And very excited for you guys.
Thank you, Jeremy. I mean, people love it.
Yeah.
And that's a lot of work.
All right, cool. Well, we'll check out some sounds.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. So now we're going to go ahead and take a listen to some sounds of the Captor X. I'm with my boy Jeremy Krull here, and he's going to kind of talk us through and fiddle some knobs, and I'm just going to play this Mayones guitar, and we'll see what it sounds like through this Marshall.
How's it going? So we have Captor X, the totally new box from Two Notes, amp top, load box, and cabinet simulator. It has no displays on the front. It's all analog controls on the front, so I'm going to take you through everything. So when running an amp through Captor X, you have an output trim level, which would basically keep you from potentially damaging anything you run direct out into with your amp. And then we have this really cool knob here. It's called the voicing control. Voicing control is basically a mid-shift, and in, at the center position, it's actually neutral. If you start to turn it towards the left, you'll get a nice sort of bump in the mids, gets kind of honky and sort of frontward. If you start to go towards the right, it starts to become more modern, more scooped, possibly a little bit more clear, depending on what you're into, you know. Usually we keep it here, it's up to taste. Now, as you might have seen, the Captor X features a new reverb algorithm as well as the Trin Tracker DSP in it. So this space knob can either control stereo width or reverb depth. So I'm going to go through the six presets that are loaded right now on the front panel of the unit, and I'll demonstrate for you how the space control works and also just some of the factory cabinet settings. So we have a pretty basic one on number one. When you go to number two, well, number one, number two, and you start to mess with space. Number three also has Twin Tracker enabled, different cabs each time, obviously. As we get up to four, things become more spatial. There's more reverb involved on these factory presets. So when you're adjusting the space control, you're actually doing sort of a combination of width and reverb depths. Basically gets wetter as you go. By the time you get up to the sixth preset on the factory presets, it's pretty much huge sounding cavernous sort of long reverb. So that's sort of the external analog complement of the unit, even though all of these pots are actually tapped, so they can be adjusted from the remote, or they can be stored, and then you can adjust them to be where they are on your presets, like a recall, basically. And you also have this high and low input level, which is basically a pad, just as sort of a safety if you have a super hot amp hitting the unit. Like with this Marshall, we have this Marshall completely wide open, and it's not affecting the load box at all, but we put a little bit of a pad on it just so we had a little more headroom to work with. So, yeah, that's basically the front panel of the unit in action with an actual guitar being played into it. It's pretty easy. You can just sort of take it right out of the box and do it like this. You don't even have